Welcome to ZEISS INSPECT Airfoil. In this video, you'll learn how to perform airfoil profile inspections. We'll create the stacking point, camber line, leading and trailing edge points, and check the profile edge thickness, maximum profile thickness, profile camber and thickness distribution, as well as the profile chord line. I'll demonstrate all the inspections using optical 3D data, but the same applies to CMM data. The training data contains a solution project with the inspections for both datasets. If you want to try ZEISS INSPECT Airfoil, take a look at the description below. There, you'll find links to download the software, request a free trial, and download training data. To perform airfoil profile inspections, our project must fulfill certain prerequisites. Typically, we need nominal and actual data. I say typically because with ZEISS INSPECT Airfoil, you can also plan your inspections based on nominal data only. For more information, check out the INSPECT Airfoil Optical 3D Data Basic e-Learning or INSPECT Airfoil CMM Data Basic e-Learning. You need the alignment used for inspection. In the case of the part IGT3D, that's a local best fit over the airfoil and fillet of the HP turbine blade. Usually, an initial alignment is required before creating the alignment used for inspection. And we need the stacking axis. Now, the first three steps in the workflow support in the airfoil inspection workspace mainly concern optical 3D data. They support the creation of the elements that are required for airfoil profile inspections. With CMM data, these elements are imported and created by the function Prepare Sections for Inspection in the CMM Data Preparation workspace. Since this is a starter guide, I won't cover all the preliminary steps. Instead, we'll start with step 4, I-Inspect. If you want to work your way through the entire airfoil inspection workflow, check out the INSPECT Airfoil Optical 3D Basic e-Learning or INSPECT Airfoil CMM Data Basic e-Learning. Okay, back to our project. Let's open I-Inspect. You can use the workflow support or control and the right mouse button and place it anywhere. I-Inspect provides a dedicated airfoil profile inspection menu. But as you can see, it's not accessible right now. That's because the functions that are available in I-Inspect depend on the element or elements selected in the 3D view or the Explorer. To access the airfoil profile inspections, you must select a section. So let's select the section and display it exclusively in the 3D view, either by using drag and drop or the keyboard shortcut E. When you open the airfoil profile inspection menu, you can see that the first three functions are available, but the following ones are not. Like the main toolbar, the airfoil profile inspection menu is designed to support your workflow. The first three functions are basic functions that only require a profile section, which we have. The following eight functions require the camber line, which we'll create shortly. The next two are preliminary functions for the form and position inspection, and the last one is the form and position inspection. So let's start at the top with the stacking point. The stacking point is the intersection point between the stacking axis and the plane of the profile section. All you need to do in this dialog window is select the stacking axis, which is the Z-axis of the local coordinate system component CS. Keep the automatically generated name and click OK. Let's quickly have a look at the airfoil profile inspection menu in I-Inspect again. When you look at the profile stacking point function, you'll see that the icon is highlighted in gray. That means that the profile stacking point was created. The check mark on the right toggles the visibility of the element. Great! Now let's create the camber line. The camber line is the basis for most profile inspections, so let's take a closer look at the parameters here. We recommend keeping the automatically generated name since it references the base element, which is the profile section plane AA plus 0.00 millimeters. The software also suggests an inflow direction. In this case, that's X plus, which is correct. As you can see, ZEISS INSPECT Airfoil aims to make your life easier every step of the way. If you need to change the automatic selection, simply tick this box and change the info direction in the drop-down list. You can also invert the direction with this button here. Now in the expert parameters, you can select the method, meaning the approach used to create the camber line, and adjust the edge area extrapolation for the leading and trailing edge. And down here, you can select a measuring principle. ZEISS INSPECT Airfoil uses measuring principles to compute the corresponding actual element. We're creating the camber line based on the nominal section. The measuring principle selected here computes the camber line on the actual section. For more information about the expert parameters, including measuring principles, have a look at the tech guide. Click OK to create the camber line. Now that we created the camber line, the following airfoil profile inspections become available. Remember, these functions require the camber line. First, let's create the profile edge points for the leading and trailing edge. As you know, they're the intersection points between the camber line and the profile section. Click Profile Edge Points. In this dialog window, you can choose if you want to create the leading or trailing edge point or both. Let's create both and click OK. And here they are. Again, they have an automatically generated name referencing the profile section. Just a little side note here. At this point, you can double check if the inflow direction of the camber line is correct. If it's not, the leading and trailing edge point will be reversed. Next, let's inspect the profile edge thickness at the trailing edge. To do that, click Profile Edge Thickness in the Airfoil Profile Inspection menu. Since I only want to construct the profile edge thickness at the trailing edge, I deselect leading edge here. As an offset, I'm going to use 5 mm. And as offset method, I'll use onCamberline arc length, which is the default. As you can see, you have different options in this drop-down list. For more information about the offset method, have a look at the tech guide. In order to display the inspection result, we need to apply a check. To do that, select the profile edge thickness in the 3D view. Open Check in I-Inspect and apply the check distance. As you can see here, the software automatically checks against nominal. You can enter a tolerance, let's use 0.2 millimeters, and link the upper and lower limit. Then click OK to create the check. Next, we'll create and check the maximum profile thickness. Select the profile section. Open the Airfoil Profile Inspection menu and select Maximum Profile Thickness. In the dialog window, you can choose between two types, distance and circle. In this case, I want to use circle. Click OK. Now all that's left to do is check the element. In this case, we'll apply the check diameter. Remember, we use the type circle to inspect the maximum profile thickness, which means we can check the diameter and or radius. But since we want to check the maximum profile thickness and any associated impact on the airflow, we need to check the diameter, not the radius. Enter a tolerance and click OK to create the check. In addition to the discrete values obtained via the check Max Profile Thickness, ZEISS INSPECT Airfoil supports the continuous inspection of the profile camber and thickness with the checks Profile Camber Distribution and Profile Thickness Distribution. Their results are not only valuable for final inspections, but can support design and reverse engineering. I want to show you the profile thickness distribution. You can choose whether you want to create the distribution on the camber line or the chord line. As you can see in the preview, the results look different depending on your selection. When you select distribution on chord line, the profile thicknesses are projected on the chord line and then halved. The distances are displayed as vectors perpendicular to the chord line, but I'll use on camber line. You can use a fixed point distance. In this case, the point distance is computed along the camber line because of our selection here. For more detailed information about the function, please look at the tech guide. Once you've created the element, apply the check distance relative mapping along curve length. Set a tolerance, plus minus 0.3 millimeters, for example, and click OK to create the check. Change the legend to 0.3 millimeters. Now you can see the results in the 3D view as a colored deviation representation. You could apply deviation labels to obtain discrete values, but you can also display the results in the diagram. To better visualize the relative deviations, we can change the x-axis of the diagram. Open Diagram Settings, and in the tab Curve, under Projection X-axis, select Curve Length Percent. Now, what does this result, the comparison in percentage of the length, actually mean? Say we want to inspect the difference between nominal and actual at this nominal point here. The first step is to compute its relative position on the camber line length, or the chord line length, depending on your selection in the creation dialog. In this case, that's 20% of the camber line length. Then, we'd compute the same actual point at 20% of the actual camber line length. As you can see here, the absolute position is different because the length of the nominal and actual camber lines are different. Once we have these two relative locations, we compute the thickness at these locations and then the deviation value. If you want, you can export the diagram. So far, so good. The last inspection I want to show you in this section is the profile chord line. Remember to select the profile section again. Then click Profile Chord Line in the Airfoil Profile Inspection menu. Under Type, you can choose different computation methods for the chord line. I'll use axial chord. The axial chord line is generally determined parallel to the machine axis, or any other axis. In this case, we'll use the x-axis of the component coordinate system. But you could also use the y-axis, for example. Calipers are used to measure the chord line. The faces of the caliper are perpendicular to the selected axis. They're visualized as orange lines here. For more information about the different types of chords, check the tech guide. Please note that you can create multiple chord lines using different types. Since I only want to create one, I'll click Create and Close. Now all that's left to do is check the chord line. Select it and open Check. Apply the check distance. As tolerance, I'll use plus minus 0.3 millimeters. Now if you don't like the way the check is displayed, crossing the profile section, select the check within the label. Then click on the circular handle here and drag the line to where you want it. The check is now separated from the element. Hide the element using the keyboard shortcut I, and you're done. Now, if you ever made a mistake or need to make changes to an element, don't delete it. You can simply select it and use Edit Creation Parameters or press F4. Say you want to change the computation method for the camber line to skeleton line. All you need to do is select the camber line in the 3D view or the Explorer, right-click it and select Edit Creation Parameters or simply press F4. Make the changes, in this case I'll change the method, and click OK. And ZEISS INSPECT Airfoil automatically recalculates all the dependent elements. Remember, these elements depend on the camber line. And as you can see, the results are automatically recalculated based on your changes. So don't worry if you need to make changes. The software keeps track of dependencies and adjusts your results automatically. Let's create a report page to document the results for the profile inspection. To do that, simply display the elements you want on your report page in the 3D view. Drag labels to arrange them. Then in the main toolbar, click Create Report Page, which is the last step in the workflow support. Name the report page and select a style. Now the last thing I want to show you in this video is a section view. Currently, it's empty, and as you can see here, activating the section view changes the Explorer. To see all the elements in the Explorer, click here. Drag and drop the profile section into the section view. The section view displays all the elements that are in the same plane as the profile section. Why is that useful? Usually, you'll inspect more than one profile section. The section view allows you to display all the elements and checks that are in the same plane simply by selecting one single element in the Explorer and dragging it into the section view. You can use the section view for report pages by selecting the style section. When you click Edit Content here, you can also select a scale. And you can use it to create tags. With tags, you can group elements that belong together. They're basically containers for elements like nominal, actual, and inspection elements that help you stay organized. As you've seen, we created quite a few elements and checks. In the section view, you can use Select All Elements of Section View to select all the elements. Then use the keyboard shortcut T to create a tag. Name it. I'll call it Profile_inspections. Please note that spaces are not supported for tag names. Let's deactivate the section view so I can show you the tag I just created. In the Explorer, you'll find a separate category for tags. As I said, tags are containers for elements. You can drag and drop them into the 3D view to display all the elements and checks you grouped within the tag. Great! Now, I know this was a lot, so let's briefly summarize it. You learned that you need a main alignment, a profile section, and, if required, a stacking axis to perform airfoil profile inspections. You got to know the airfoil profile inspection menu in I-Inspect, which is step 4 of the workflow support. So far, we created basic inspection elements, the profile stacking point and camber line, and we constructed some camber line dependent inspections. You learned that you need to apply checks to inspection elements to display the results. You also learned how to create a report page, how to use the section view, and how to create tags to stay organized. If you want to find out how to perform an airfoil profile form and position inspection, take a look at the next video in this playlist. And if you're looking for a more comprehensive training, check out the Inspect Airfoil Optical 3D Data Basic e-learning or the Inspect Airfoil CMM Data Basic e-learning. You'll find the links in the description below.